on Scottish. Now on Scottish television, it's time for Des O'Connor Tonight.
Chestnuts. Get the youngest off to bed. I don't care if he is 36. Get him off the bed. It's Christmas Eve, and we're gonna have a little fun.
It seems there's no end to the money we spend at Christmas. With so many friends, it seems to cost more each year. But we'll never change, and why rearrange the day that we love so dear? And though we complain, we'll do it again next year.
Well, I'm going to enjoy tonight's show, because I got one day off at Christmas, and then on Boxing Day, I'm down to Plymouth, and I'm in pantomime. Oh, yes, I am. Well, let me tell you this, we have a marvellous show for you tonight. Oh, yes, I do. This lot's gone mad in here tonight. We have a marvellous show for you tonight. A man who could, well, he could be described as anything but a silent knight. Sir Robin Day is joining us in here for a bit of chat. And we're going to try and get Robin to do something else as well tonight. Bernie Clifton will be galloping in here with a beautiful bird. That'll be a bit of fun. And looking to the crowd before I came in, I thought, what a crew, what a motley lot. We've got to try and appeal across the board, and we are doing that tonight. Musical taste for everyone, from musical comedy. We have Susan Hampshire, who's starring right now in The King and I, and she's going to be doing a song in full costume with all the kids from the Royal Palace at Siam from The King and I. That'll be beautiful. Susan Hampshire. And for all you popsters out there, here with their new old Bananarama in here, and they're going to do their stuff. And we're guaranteed lots of laughs, because one of the masters of the game is here with us tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Bob Monkhouse, your laugh. Little Bob will do it. Now, the the first guest tonight, we broke the golden rule. We invited a comic back who'd already been on the series because he was on about 3 weeks ago and he made us laugh so much. I said, we've got to have that guy back for Christmas. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome Jethro? Myself comfortable, and I said I'd like you back, but I'd like you to help out as a barman.
So that's it, is it? Well, I sound drunk anyway, don't I?
Last time you were on, we got some letters saying, was that fella slosh?
But that's... Well, I'll look like a barman.
You're going to look like
No, it's all right. I picked it up off the floor anyway. So he's all right. Is this mine, Desmond?
Yeah, and have you got one for me? I was told you could have a bourbon for me, a lemonade or something. Here's mine. They've hidden it away.
Oh, that's right.
Now, you tell me, because I don't drink champagne, you tell me what's going on in Cornwall since the last time you were there.
Oh, that Denzel Pemberthy, you know my mate.
Denzel, you've got to hear about Denzel.
Yeah, he's stupid, he is. He is stupid. He is, and that's official now.
That's official.
He's stupid, he is. You won't believe how stupid he is.
Tell me.
He is stupid. Everybody's saying how stupid he is. We've had the Antique Roadshow down, and I
the
said...
What?
The Antique Roadshow.
Oh, I've
the
seen.
Antique Roadshow. Pay attention.
I'm listening.
And I said to Denzel, you must come down to the Antique Roadshow and bring an old relic down, and the man will tell you what it is and how much that it's worth. He said, I shall have a look in the attic and see what I can find. I said, that's right. You look in the attic and see what you can find. And bring it down, and the man will tell you what it is. He said, I'll have a look. And he got down there with an enormous parcel. It was the biggest parcel that was there. And he unwrapped it. He said, how long has this been in your family? Well, Denzel said, it's been in the attic for about 70 years. It's never been out the attic before. And I'm hoping you'll be able to tell me what it is. He said, I can't tell you what it is. He said, it's a water tank. But I've had a problem. A man knocked my door, and he did. He walked straight in. He said, Jethro, he said, you haven't paid for your double glazing. I said, well, you told me in 12 months he'd pay for himself.
I want to hear more about Denzel, because he seems to be a real character. What's he been up to? What's he been doing? Tell us some more about him.
Well, I haven't heard this. I haven't heard this for months, this story. I never laughed last time. No, what he's set a business now. He's self-employed now as an oil well firefighter.
Mm-hmm.
As an oil well firefighter. He's got a Morris 1000 van with an MOT certificate.
What's he got?
A Morris 1000 van with an MOT certificate. Because he's an international oil well firefighter.
Oh, I see. He'd need that, wouldn't he?
He would need it. And
he
was in business for 3 weeks and never had a job, not one.
Not a lot of oil well.
Not in Trebogus.
No.
And then an oil peak had his oil well all on fire, and he rung Red Adair, because he does that sort of thing as well as Pemberthy. And he said, is that Red Adair? He said, we've got an oil well on fire. I'm prepared to pay £1 million to have it put out. He said, can you come and do it? Well, Red Adair said, I can't come. He said, I'm right in the middle of Pepper and the Landing.
Who said that?
Red Adair. He was Pepper and the Landing.
Oh, Red Adair.
So he said, is there anybody else that does this sort of work? Well, he said, you're very lucky. Because there's a firm just opened up in Trebogus in Cornwall. He said, it's Pemberthy Firefighters, Trebogus. Well, he said, what is his telephone number? Ah, now he said, Ian on the phone. He said, you've got to telephone the kiosk 6 o'clock. everybody think? So he rung, and hello, he said, Penberthy Firefighters, Trebogus, Camborne. He said, Mr. Penberthy, he said, rather there, I'd give me your key off number. And he said that you can come and put my fire out. I got flames leaping 500 feet into the air. I'm prepared to pay £1 million, have it done. Can you come and do it? Well, Denzel said, that is my job. I am an international firefighter. But he said, I can't come tonight, he said, because it's a scout's disco. And I normally do the raffle, see? Well, he said, look, he said, you'll see the fire from the air, and he said, you land your airplane in the desert, right beside the fire, and you'll be on the job, and there'll be no trouble. Well, Denzel said, I'll see you tomorrow, if it's a nice day. Well, he thought, I shan't see any more of Penberthy. But sure enough, next morning, in come a big troop carrying an airplane. He thought, well, that's Penberthy. And he landed on the desert, and out come a ram and the short wheelbase Land Rover loaded with boys from Camborne, all on the dole. It's Tuesday. And he drove right across, he nearly knocked the sheik down. He said, hi, hoo, ah, he said, which meant, steady, Penberthy, you plunker, he said. That's what he meant. And he said, I don't believe he's going to stop that Land Rover. And he was loaded with boys, and he drove straight for the fire. He says, steady. And you know, he never stopped. He never stopped. He drove straight in the middle of all these flames with this Land Rover and all these boys. Well, the boys thought, well, that's he dead. He burnt that lot. And the Land Rover. And he had four good tires, the Land Rover did as well. And he could just look through the flames, and all these boys had jumped off and started to stamp the fire out with their feet. They had enormous great boots on.
Yes, they would, wouldn't they?
During an hour and three quarters, they had this fire out.
Just by stamping?
Just by stamping. It's wonderful how it all works, isn't it? And he went over, and by this time, Penberthy and all his team was the same color. He said, which one of you colored gentlemen is Penberthy? And I said, I'm Penberthy, firefighter, Trebogus. Well, he said, I think the way you've gone about this job is fantastic. I said, I've never been so impressed, never in all my life. He said, I thought sure you would stop that Land Rover before you got to the fire. But he said, not you. He said, you drove right in the middle of that fire and started work. And he said, I think it's fantastic. He said, your dedication to your job. And he said I'd pay you £1 million. And £1 million I'll pay. And he said, what do you think you're going to do with the money? Well, Denzel said, I think the first job is to have the brakes looked at on the Land Rover.
Yes, Robin, let him step up.
Now you know why we invited Jethro back, and he'll be back again and again. And now here's another old friend who zipped down the motorway to join us. He's come down from his pantomime in Mansfield. Will you please welcome, with his friend, please welcome Bernie Clifton! I know what you're thinking. It's rubbish, but it's British. Easy now. Stay. The problem is, what am I going to tell my grandchildren I did for a living? No. I was nearly off then. You'd get a shock if I did come off. All right, missus, have you worked it out yet? Good. Now, parents out there watching, you should be doing what I'm doing. Fight back. Embarrass your children. What's that noise? Hey. Easy, whoa. Whoa, Dad.
Hey, Dad. If leg was...
it was in your room. All I did was pop me leg over.
Yeah, that's what they all say, Dad. What? Easy.
Mine.
Easy now.
Is it really frisky, this one?
Oh, the thing is, you see, mine's a hen. Yeah. Yours is a cock.
Well, tell her not to bury her head in the sand.
Hey, sorry,
Link, did you? You got a visitor.
Whoa, stop it, please.
It's really frisky. What's the matter with it?
Well, he's never been the same since today, since somebody shouted, "Packs off!" Now what they do?
What's going on?
Well, the trouble is, Dad, it's that time of the year, you know.
You mean, Well, I'm not sure I'm ready for this.
Tell you what, Des, you might not be, but I think they are.
What do we do?
Don't worry, just do as I do, Des. Just watch the feet, okay?
Okay.
Ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4.
That this fertility dance stuff works for them?
Absolutely, sir. Listen, here's last year's results.
Where?
Come here, Chuck.
Bernie Chuck and Elisa Lake, down one, little Bernie.
Come on, come on, here we go.
Go! Into these things. Ladies and gentlemen, we're delighted to welcome three more beautiful birds with a hit record, Bananarama.
Thank you.
up on them. Hello, baby. Here.
Can you remember that wedding in Tuscany?
Could I forget it?
Amaretto di Saronno.
You'll never forget your first time.
Here we are, the jolly old men at last, Jeeves. And there's a spiffing spot.
I would not advocate it, sir.
Jeeves, don't talk such rot. Onwards!
Very well, sir.
Ah, the tang of the salt breezes, Jeeves.
Yes, sir.
The gentle heaving of the waves.
Exactly, sir.
Yo-ho-ho, Jeeves. In fact, I'll go further. Yo-ho-ho, and a bottle of craft. Oh, Jeeves. Nothing like a splash of light, chilled craft original dancing over the old taste buds. I feel absolutely in the pink, Jeeves.
I fear you're not alone, sir.
Suddenly large.
I say, Jeeves.
Craft original, one instinctively knows when something is right.
Wow.
There are thousands of bargains and interest-free credit in the Lewis's sale. Starts Boxing Day, 10 a.m.
Wow.
Just one more greeting to add to the 1.5 billion we've already delivered this Christmas.
Hey, Santa, have you heard about Lumpolly's January sale? There's up to £150 off per person.
£150 each? Get away.
Which of these people have sensitive teeth? They all do. As your dentist will tell you, it's a common problem. But she uses...
fresh-tasting Sensodyne Acid Fluoride. I use it every day, and it helps keep my breath fresh.
Sensodyne F special ingredient quickly helps calm the nerves that cause pain. Now they all use fresh-tasting Sensodyne F to relieve the pain of sensitive teeth.
Stop! My head's spinning with the quality, choice and value in the Reed Furniture Sale.
From a factory store, direct to your door.
If you want to know more about food additives, write for your free copy of the booklet, Food Additives, The Balanced Approach.
Now, when one of our foremost actresses decides, I'd like to do a musical, well, I want to know why. Will you please welcome Susan Hampshire?
Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas. Happy Christmas, kids. Now, this is not your first go at a musical, though, is it?
No, I started off in musicals and then I did Little Night Music last year, so I have done musicals, but the first one was years and years and years ago.
But this
is new for me, really.
But this is big, you know, the King and I with all the kids.
Are
these yours?
Well, each place we go to, we have new children, and we have new children in London where we're going to be in
when
a month's
are you
going to
be
time.
Here?
We're going, 6th of February, we're going to the Sadler's Wells for 2 months until the 30th of March. We'll have new children, and these are the children we have in Birmingham, and they're absolutely adorable.
They are lovely kids. Yeah. Hello, kids! Oh, very nice. Now, this has been on the road since September.
Yes.
And you're going to go through, as you say, to February.
Yes.
You must love the part or the frock. What is it?
I love the part. I love the part and I love the children. Working with children as nice as this is really, really a joy. And you get each town you go to, you fall in love with the children. It's like having a new family. It's so enjoyable.
Well, Susan, I know it's one of my favourite musicals anyway. And I know you're just about, you're playing the governess.
That's right.
As much as I am to teach the children all the good things. I know you're going to give them a lesson, so how do I say bye-bye to them?
For many years before I came here, Siam was to me just like a little spot on the map. But now that I've been teaching here for more than a year, I've met the people of Siam, and I'm beginning to understand them.
You like us, Mrs. Anna?
Oh, I like you very much indeed. It's a very ancient saying, but a true and honest thought, that if you become a teacher, by your pupils you'll be taught.
As a teacher, I've been learning. You'll forgive me if I boast. And I've now become an expert on the subject I like most. Getting to know you. Getting to know you. Getting to know all about you. Getting to like you. Getting to hope you like me. Getting to know you. Putting it my way, but nicely. You are precisely my cup of tea. Getting to know you. Getting to feel free and easy. When I am with you, getting to know what to say. Haven't you noticed? Suddenly I'm bright and breezy. Because of all the beautiful and new things I'm learning about you. Getting to know you, getting to know all about you. Getting to like you, getting to hope you like me. Getting to know you, putting it my way, but nicely. You are precisely my cup of tea. Getting to know you, getting to feel free and easy. When I'm with you, getting to know what to say. Haven't you noticed? Suddenly I'm bright and breezy. Because of all the beautiful and new things I learn about you. Day by day.
The King and I. Now, I'm pleased to have my next guest back. He was on our last series. Everybody loved him. And why not? Sir Robin Day!
Good evening. How do you do?
How do you do?
Sir Robin! The crowd are pleased to see you, and I am. This is a great honour.
For you, Mr. O'Connor, or for me?
It's an honour for me, Sir Robin, to have a man of such distinction as yourself on the show.
Well, it is Christmas time, and we want a classless society, so I'm trying to help the unfortunate.
I'd be much happier if you would think about calling me Dez.
Oh. All right. Well, could we get on with the interview? I'd be happier if we could do that, Les.
Yeah, but
Des.
I don't want to interview you.
You want me to interview you? What would I interview you about?
Well, I mean, Sir Robin, let me explain. What I'm really interested in is if I
could... Could you get to the point, please?
Yeah.
Les.
Des. I'm very anxious to give the show a more distinguished...
I can well understand your anxiety.
I've heard an awful lot about you singing.
I've heard a lot about your awful... I've heard an awful lot about your singing.
Look, I'm told you have a pleasing and pleasant singing voice.
Absolute balderdash. I only sing in my bath.
Yeah, well, you're obviously much too modest.
Oh, that has always been my trouble, I know.
But are you too modest on a Christmas evening to sing a duet with me?
But I don't just sing with anyone, Les. Des.
We have here... A 30-piece, Sir Robin, a 30-piece orchestra assembled especially for us. The recording company will be very disappointed
in this. A recording company?
Yes, you'd go right to the top of the charts.
What, with your name on the label?
But what about it?
As Margaret Thatcher says, no, no, no.
All right, I'm getting there. Okay. I'll just, thank you very much, and I'll just have to call someone else, like,
Righto.
Ludwig Kennedy.
Yes. I think you're a very nice chap. Your show is getting better every moment.
Yes.
And I would, on second thoughts, like to sing a duet with you if you can find a song that you know that
well,
I can sing.
I know you like Flanagan and Allen.
Well, I've heard of them.
Colin, could you? This is Mr. Colin Keyes, my musical director.
Oh, is he your musical director? Yeah. Bad luck, old boy.
If you're going to do Flanagan and Allen, there's only one way to rub in. You can do it, right?
And God, it's hot in here.
It is hot. And the song we're going to do, plus the verse, right?
A what?
The verse, you're good with the verse? Have you got the verse?
The verse, yes.
Underneath the artist. Maestro, take it away.
See. You first.
The writs we never sighed for.
The Carlton they can keep.
There's only one place that I know.
And that is where we sleep. Underneath the arches, we dream our dreams away. Underneath the arches, on cobblestones we lay. Every night you'll find us tired out and happy when the daylight comes creeping, heralding the dawn, sleeping when it's rising, and sleeping when it's fine. We'll hear the train rattling by. Pavement is my pillow, no matter where we stray. Underneath the arches, we dream our dreams away.
Thank you very much, my
friend.
They're calling for more out there.
I mean,
more what?
Listen, hello, Joe.
Now, what do you know?
I just got back
from a rodeo show.
Yes, we could do that.
Down in Arizona, where the Batman
are. Tell us.
The only thing I do is the evening star. The roughest, toughest man by far. Ragtime cowboy Joe. He always sings. Ragtime music to the Cadillac swing. Back and forward in the saddle on a horse.
On a horse.
Cause he's incapacitated under the sun. Capone meter from the roar of his ravine.
How they run.
When they hear the fellas come, because the western folks all know.
How they know?
He's a highfalutin, rootin', shootin' son of a gun from Arizona. Ragtime cowboy, I talk about a cowboy. A ragtime cowboy, Joe.
Oh, there you are. That's not bad, is it?
Thank you very much.
The Robin Day. We're back in a couple of minutes. The Robin Day. The Bob Monkhouse, don't go away. What?
Your friend, Harvey, what did he come at?
A glass of sherry.
Oh, brilliant.
Drink Harvey's Bristol Cream.
Now, let's see how good your powder really is.
On muck like this, my old powder had its work cut out.
It did pretty well, considering. Then I discovered Ariel Ultra. Who'd think something this simple would make such a difference?
Look, with socks this filthy, this is sometimes what the best traditional powder can do, but Ariel Ultra gives you visibly better cleaning.
And with my look, could I settle for anything less?
Ariel Ultra. Visibly better cleaning.
When you tuck your children in at night, are you putting them to bed or laying them to rest? If inhaled, the smoke from a house fire could kill a small child in under a minute. They'll rely on you to wake them up and get them out. What are you relying on? Wake up. Get a smoke alarm.
box.
To the latest news. The ultimate newspaper, brought to you by Oracle.
Eve, we have a happy audience. I like to eat on Christmas Eve and drink on Christmas Eve, and we all like to laugh, don't we?
Yeah.
We're gonna do just that. Here's Bob Monkhouse.
Thank you, folks. An early Merry Christmas to you. Are you enjoying the festivities so far? Little drinky poo, by the way.
Yeah, I'll take that, Des. And Merry Christmas to you too, my friend.
And to good folks out there.
Yeah. Very Merry Christmas. Very lovely. And those who are not seeing us, absent friends. I'm thinking about it. When one thinks about Christmas, we get nativity plays. And we all dress. Most people put the Arab headdress on, don't they? To be the, standing around in the nativity play as the shepherds. And it makes you realize that Arabs are not that different from you and me. The only difference, I think, between the Arab people and us is they do everything the other way around from us. You know, they read the other way around, and they write the other way around. You're in the Middle East, you commit adultery, you get stoned. Now, you and I do that the other way around. I love it, Rob. I remember at Christmas Eve, I'll take you back 10 years now, we went round an old folks' home Christmas Eve about 1980-79. Do you remember this at all?
Vaguely. We've been out on a few evenings, you and I, over the years.
Yeah, but this particular time, we spent about half an hour going round an old folks' home, and we were leaving, and you said no, and you went back. There was a little old lady that no one had spoken to. She wasn't communicating with anybody, and she was tucked in the corner, in the bed in the corner, and you went over to her, and you held her hand, and you sang to her softly. I think you sang her every song that you've ever had in the Hit Parade. And you said to her, when you finished, you said, "I hope you get better soon." And the little old lady said, "You too, Dave."
You never stopped it.
You knew it was coming.
You rightly know as the king of the game shows. I mean, you must have done more than anybody, and done them as well as anybody could possibly do. How many have you done? Do you have a list? Oh,
gosh, I don't know. I'm...
5, 6, 7?
But I don't know, Des, honestly. It'd be a bit egocentric of me to try and... If I'd be obsessed with my own career, if I could remember them all, try and name one or two. Let's see, there's What's My Line, The Name's the Same, and Find the Link, and I've Got a Secret, and Trust Your Wife, and Beat the Clock, and Box the House, and Bury Your Hatchet, and Cricket the Draw, the Golden Shot, Celebrity Squares, and Family Fortune. I'll never recall the name of the one. I just don't care. Give me what you like, Chris Hutchinson. Put on this. I love game shows, and I love quizzes.
Well, they tell me that, having done so many, you've now got a hobby of collecting bizarre facts. I suppose that must come close to the territory, doesn't it?
Frogs.
What about frogs?
Frogs mate underwater.
Really?
That surprises you. I was surprised. First time I went to the public bars in France, I was astonished at that. And I want to tell you what amazed me on, again, on a wildlife program, female giraffes. Do you know, a female giraffe, during mating, will sometimes get bored and walk away. My God, I'm married to a giraffe. It's all true. No mistake.
It's very interesting, all that. I mean, it's a whole study there, isn't it? Now, you never make mistakes, do you, Bob, on these game shows?
I think it's very important if you're a quiz master on a show where someone's going to win a prize that's important to them to make sure you make no mistakes. So I try to make none.
Well, I'd just like you to take a look at this clip we've got, Bob.
What?
It's of your good self actually making a little boo-boo. And it's a good one, too.
As you answer, you'll see a picture form on the video wall, and that'll be an illustration of your key question. Enough about that till we get to it. In the first part, thank you very much.
Oh, how did we get that before Dennis Norden.
That hasn't gone out yet, series.
That's why we thought it was a little bit of a coup, because that doesn't go out until next...
Starts in January, with the $64,000 question. I'm glad you didn't get the clip where I was talking about folk songs from Poland.
We'll look for it.
No, that was... we've done such a lot, you know, and... But on that show, $64,000 question, you get such eccentric people. They're lovely people, but they specialize in one topic. They have to know all about one topic.
With a family, do you get a passenger now and again?
You get an Uncle Ernie on the end, who's definitely a danger.
Sound like we struck her. Is an Uncle Ernie here?
You get the one that the family didn't want to bring, sitting on the end. They shove him down the end. I hope you'll never get to him. And you do. Hello, Uncle Ernie.
I did.
Name the capital of France. F. Oh. we had a family on once. Did I ever tell you about this? An Irish family.
No.
Sweet family from Northern Ireland. But their family name was Thicke, T-H-I-C-K-E. Now, there being so many Irish jokes about, and that being racist these days, I went out to the studio audience before we recorded the show and said, please don't laugh at this. It is the genuine family name, but let's not make a joke of it. So they were very good. The studio audience was sweet about it. And I said to the... You remember on Family Fortunes that Les Dennis does now, that each of the answers comes from the public. It's a survey of 100 people who ask the questions. So it's what you've got from the public. So I go to this dear lady who was head of the family. I said, we asked 100 people to name something blue. I think the top answer was the sky, then the sea, etc. We asked her to name... We asked 100 people to name something blue. She said,
is it my cardigan?
So now I'm dreading coming back to this woman again. We come round to the second question. My second question was, name something deserted in winter. I think the top answer was a nudist camp, maybe a swimming pool, a seafront. Name something deserted in winter.
My cousin Elsie.
And the audience laughed as you just did, and she turned on them.
She said, it's not funny with 5 kids in the house and Christmas coming up.
Those are free gifts out of from the god of comedy.
That's right. Gold nuggets dropping in your lap, if you like. You probably know, I don't know if you do know, but I wander around the crowd and I get questions from the audience for you. So it's an air of spontaneity as they feel they're joining. I'm trying to remember the 4 questions. There was one, how did you become a comedian?
Who asked that? I'm glad somebody thinks I did.
We've got 4. When do you go? We're doing one at a time. How do you become a comedian?
Right. Well, I mean, you've been asked that question. I've been asked, how do you get started? This morning it was an AA man and some jump leads.
I think
a man becomes a comedian rather in the same way that a girl enters the oldest profession. You start doing it for fun, and then you do it for a few friends.
And then you think, hey, I might as well get paid for this.
Someone over here said, are you gonna get into my territory? You're gonna start singing and making records?
No, I will leave that to you. Yeah, I make all these jokes about you, as all comedians do, but I'm a great fan of yours. I think you're a marvellous singer. Your first record. I do.
I'll give you the money later.
I went out and bought your very first record. I remember it was Callous Hands, first hit.
Yes.
It was 78.
Yes.
And then you had a 45, and then you had a 33. I think it's the cold weather that's shrinking in. Now you're lucky if you sell a dozen.
What's the strangest...
Oh, talking of records, could we mention this?
I know you want to talk about that.
Just very briefly, it's the spoken word of rock and roll. I'm only saying that what is great about it is dozens of stars, dozens of them, Doddy and Ian McCaskill and Claire Rayner and Robert Powell, and if I'm not naming them, we'd run out of time, have done the spoken word of rock and roll. And if you purchase this album, you will not only be helping us to help people who are disabled with cerebral palsy through the Stars Organization for Spastics, but you'll also be buying yourself the biggest laugh. It is the funniest since your last album. This one is really...
I know that's a cause very close to your heart.
It is.
We'll say it again, the spoken word of rock and roll.
Thank you, Dave.
Brad, someone said, and I think I'm right, did you ask about Bernie the Bolt, someone up there?
Yeah.
Johnny Baker and Derek. There was the two guys. One was called Johnny Baker. The other, lovely man called Derek. I still see him at the Central Studios. He's still the top technician there and a marvellous guy. We had so many things go wrong with that show. Everybody had to be on qui vive all the time. You know, it was a live show. For those of you who never saw it, too young to remember, the idea of the show was that people at home could affect events in the studio. They could see a target live projected on the television set. It had to be. And they're seeing it through a camera which was mounted on a crossbow looking down through a sight with a quarrel or a bolt loaded on board. I would say, Bernie, the bolt. He'd put the bolt on. They would then say, up a bit, stop, right a bit, stop, left a bit, stop, down a bit, stop, fire, and hit an apple which would explode with a detonator in the center. And then they'd qualify to come on the show the following week. Now, this went on for the first series and the second, and then we're in the middle of the second series. And I got a phone call from a guy, ostensibly from Wolverhampton. Hello, who's calling the Golden Shot? Well, we had a little chat. Yes, I do. Yes, this what I do. Yes. So I said, right, are you ready to try? Yes, Boop. Yes, I'm ready to try. Right, Bernie, the bolt. You have 30 seconds to hit your apple, sir, starting now. Righty beat, righty beat, righty beat, righty beat. Righty beat, righty beat. Just hold it a second. Righty beat, hold. Sorry, Boop. You've gone way off the target, sir. You've gone way over to the right. Could you come back a little? Left? Left? Yes. Left a beat, left a beat, left a beat, left a beat, left a beat. Hold it. Left a beat. No, now you've gone up the other side. You're pointing in the toilet. Look, can you, stop the clock a second. Can you see the target all right on the set, sir? See? I told the man from Rumble House. I'm sorry? When he come and took the set back Wednesday. They took the set back. Yes. I've got 12 million people watching this live. You mean you're sitting at home without a television set trying to play the game? He's now need to get sarky, Bob. Keep your shirt on, if you please. I'm sorry, sir. Well, I'm not sitting at home. I'm not an idiot. I'm in a phone box. A phone box. Yes. Then you can't see a television set. Excuse me. My phone box is opposite Curry's. Curry's leave their television sets on in the window, Bob, if you haven't noticed. No, I can see you clear as day, thank you very much, Mr. Sarcastic.
I do apologize, sir.
Wife to us then. Go on, wife.
I am waving.
Are you? Yes. Oh, crumbs, I got them tuned into the bloody boo-boos.
Well, we like our last Christmas and we like our carols. And here's a group who really know how to sing their carols. They are the London Community Gospel Choir, and they sing beautifully, and it's different too.
Bless you, Mary, gentlemen. Let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ, our Savior. He was born on Christmas Day to rescue us from Satan's power when we were gone astray.
drop of rain that falls, the flower grows. I believe that somewhere in the darkest night, the candle glows. I believe for everyone who goes astray, someone will come to show the way. I believe above the storm, smallest prayer will still be heard. And I believe that someone in that great somewhere hears every word. Every time I hear a newborn baby cry or touch the leaves,
Christmas to you. Merry Christmas.
Next on ITV, Inspector Wexford. Des O'Connor's back next week on Wednesday at 8 o'clock, and he's currently appearing in Cinderella at the Theatre Royal Plymouth, while Susan Hampshire's in The King and I at the Alexandra Theatre, Birmingham.